Bitwise operators. Since everything in computers is stored in terms of ones and zeros, bitwise operators are really the strength of C, where they're used for low-level programming involving operating systems, compilers, and something called as systems programming. So if you're going to write device drivers, you'll be doing a lot of bitwise or bit manipulation in the programming, and there C happens to be an excellent language for doing the bit manipulation. With bitwise operators, you need to be careful. Some of the behavior or some of the output of the bitwise operators depends on the machine or the hardware. So on one machine, it could give you one output. On another machine, it could give you another output. So C leaves it to the compiler and the hardware to determine what output is going to come. So C has six operators for bit manipulation. Okay. Now these operators work on character type of data, signed character, unsigned character, short int, signed int and unsigned int, and long signed as well as unsigned. So this is the area of where the bitwise operators are going to work. So first, let's try to take a look at the different bitwise operators in C. Then we are in this session just going to discuss about the right shift and left shift bitwise operators. So the first bitwise operator I'm going to show you here is the bitwise AND. This is the bitwise OR, and this is the bitwise exclusive OR or the XOR. This stands for the bitwise right shift, bitwise left shift, and this stands for the ones complement. All right, ones complement, what it does is it makes ones as zeros and zeros as ones. So in order to understand this, what we shall do now is we shall take the assistance of a small program. Okay, taking a look at this program, it should give you a fair idea of how the shift operator works in C. So what I have done here is I have declared three variables, x is equal to 2, y is equal to 3, and z is equal to minus 8. Then what I am doing here is I am showing you left shift and right shift. Alright, so the left shift is generally not going to be a problem, because whether it's a signed or an unsigned number, when it shifts left, the vacant right bits are always going to be filled with zeros on any machine. But the right shift is a little tricky, that I'll tell you in the third example. So here what I have done is x is 2, I have represented 2 in binary here. Y is 3, I have represented 3 in binary here. Z is minus 8, I have just represented plus 8 here. I'll show you how I make it minus 8, and then I'll show you the following step. Here what I have done is I have taken x and I'm shifting it by 3 bits to the left. So what will happen is in each of the step, let's show it stepwise what will happen. So in the first step, okay, this bit will move here. So this is going to be 1, 0. So one bit has moved. In the second step, what is going to happen is the bit is going to move one more place. In the third step, this one is going to come here. Everything else is going to be zeros. Now, if you convert this number into decimal, this is going to be equal to 16. And this is the new value of x. So x now is 16, because x was shifted by 3 bits to the left. What you mean is when you shift a bit to the left once, it is as good as multiplying it by 2. When you shift it twice, it is good as multiplying it by 4. And when you shift it again, it's as good as multiplying it by 2 again. So it's at 4 into 2, 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 2, 8, 8 into 2, 16. So it goes to the power of 2 raised to the power. So now let's take a look at this right shift. I have 16 as it is. I am right shifting it by 2 bits. So what is happening is in the first one, this is going to happen 0, 0. This fellow is going to go. This is going to be 1 and 0. Okay, now what I am doing here is again, I am again moving it by one more bit. So it is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. This is 4 in decimal. So when I take 16 and I shift it by 2 bits to the right, it is as good as dividing by 2 every time. So 16 divided by 2 is 8. 8 divided by 2 is 4. So each shifting to the right is as good as division by 2. Each shifting to the left is as good as multiplication by 2. Now let's take a look at the third one. Z is equal to minus 8. So Z is Z right shifted by 2. Now this is 8. Alright, if I have to make it minus 8, I'll use the 2's complement. In 2's complement, first 0's become 1 and 1's become 0's. Then I am going to add 1 to this. So if I add 1 to this, this is 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1 and 1. So this is the representation of minus 8 in 2's complement. Now what I am doing with this is, now I am saying right shift this by 2 bits. Here is a problem. If I have a negative number, and if it is represented using a signed representation or 2's complementation number, if I shift it, on some machines, this may become minus 2. On some machines, all the vacant bits may get filled up with 1's. So, right shift of a signed number is machine to machine dependent. That's why you need to be extremely careful to not write code of trying to shift right bit. So, I'm trying to shift a number, a signed number to the right, because you're not sure on which machine it will give you what output. The moral of the story is quite clear. If you right shift an unsigned number, no problem. All the vacant bits on the left will be filled up with zeros. If you right shift a signed number, on some machines it will fill up with the signed bit, which may be 0 or 1s, and on some machine it will fill up with 0 bits. So that's why you need to exercise caution. Avoid right shifts unless required, because it is going to hurt the portability of your program. The reason it's going to hurt portability is you're not sure on which machine it is, your program is going to be run, and how the right shift behavior for a negative number is going to work. So just be aware of when you're working with right shift on machines.